ದಿನ ಅನುಕ್ಷಣ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ಕಲಿಕೆಯ ಹೊಸ ಹಾದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊತೆಗೂಡಿ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಯ ಹಾಕೋಣ ಸಂತಸದಿ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ನಮ್ಮ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯ ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್
ಎಸ್ ಟೀಚರ್
ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
Hi children, how are you? Are you fine? Okay, me too fine. Thank you. Welcome to 8th standard third language English, that is supplement reading lesson number 1, Savitribai Phule. Dear children, before going to the lesson, I'd like to ask you one question that is belongs to motivational questions. This question will motivate you to the lesson. Shall I ask you one question? Yes. You can see that question on screen. Who was the first female teacher of the first women's school in India? Once again, please. Who was the first female teacher of the first women's school in India? Before 1848, there was no school for women. Only men had the opportunity to going to school and getting education. But there was no opportunity before 1848. But in 1848, there are two great personalities, two persons who decided to open the school and give education to the women. They are Jyotiba Phule and Savitribai Phule. That is why the answer is Savitribai Phule was the first female teacher of the first women's school in India. Okay, dear children, in this lesson we will discuss about Savitribai Phule. Before going to the lesson, we need to understand glossary for understanding the lesson. First one is obscene. Obscene means vulgar, vulgar language. Meat. Second one, meat means dispense or allot justice or punishment or harsh treatment. Next one, tackle means to deal with. Fed up means annoyed or tired of. Next one, resistance means opposition. Orthodox means conventional or not open to change. Precinct. Precinct means area. Abandoned means to give up. Okay, dear children, I hope you have known all the meanings. Now I am going to explain the lesson, that is comprehension of text. All of you, open your English textbook and open supplementary reading lesson number 1, Savitribai Phule. You can see the picture of great personality Savitribai Phule. Okay, dear children, I am going to start the lesson now. Please see first answer. Savitribai was born on 3rd January 1831. She was the first female teacher of the first women's school in India. She was the first female teacher of the first women's school in India. In 1852, she opened a school for untouchable girls. In 1852, she opened a school for untouchable girls. Untouchable means touchable and untouchable. She was also a social reformer who, along with her husband Mahatma Jyotiba Phule, played an important role in improving women's rights in India during British rule. So Savitribai Phule, along with her husband Jyotiba Phule, played an important role in improving women's rights in India during the British rule. This is the picture of Jyotiba Phule and Savitribai Phule. These are also picture of Jyotiba and Savitribai Phule. Next answer. Mahatma Jyotiba is regarded as one of the most important figures in social reform movement in Maharashtra and India. He is most known for his efforts to educate women and the lower caste. In social reforming movement, Mahatma Jyotiba Phule is regarded or popularly known as the efforts for women, women's education and lower caste is education. I mean untouchables education. Because on those days there was no opportunity for women and lower caste girls going to school. Next, under his influence, Savitribai had taken women's education and their liberation from the cultural patterns of the male-dominated society as a mission of her life. On that time, higher caste people called male-dominated society or cultural patterns, they are not giving permission to giving education for women. That is why she worked towards tackling some of them, then major social problems including women's liberation and widow remarriages and removal of untouchability. There was no freedom for women on those days and also widow remarriages. Once women or woman become widow, they can't get marriage again, I mean remarriages. And removal of untouchability, there was untouchability. Untouchability means called lower caste people, touchability and untouchability, aspruchyate. However, apart from all the oppositions, Savitribai continued to teach the girls. There was all oppositions. Please do not teach or do not give education for women's or do not give education for lower caste people. Apart from all the oppositions, Savitribai continued to teach the girls. Whenever Savitribai went out of her house, groups of orthodox men would follow her and abuse her in obscene long ways. They would throw rotten eggs, cow dung, tomatoes and stones at her. When Savitribai Phule decided to open a school and decided to give education to women, the male dominated society abused her and followed her. When she went out of her house, they threw stones and cow dung and rotten eggs and tomatoes to Savitribai Phule. And they abused her in obscene language or vulgar language. But here is a picture of Savitribai Phule who is going to school for giving education to women. But groups of orthodox or men-dominated society throwing stones and cow dung and rotten eggs and tomatoes to Savitribai Phule. But she would walk meekly and arrive at her school. She would walk meekly and arrive at her school, fed up with the treatment meted out to her. She even decided to give up. So when the groups of men-dominated or male-dominated society or orthodox people ill-treated Savitribai Phule, she even decided to give up. But it was because of her husband Jyotiba Phule that she continued with her efforts. With the help of the advice of Jyotiba Phule, Savitribai Phule continued her teaching or her efforts. Next, Jyotiba educated and trained Savitribai is the first and ideal candidate for this job of a teacher. As I already said, On those days, there was no education facility for women. But Jyotiba Phule and Savitribai Phule, they were about to open school. That is why, before opening school, Jyotiba Phule get educated, educated his wife Savitribai Phule. Savitribai and Jyotiba faced fierce resistance from the orthodox elements of society for this. But when they were decided to open school, and when Jyotiba Phule started give education to his wife for starting a school for women, the orthodox society opposed this. When Savitribai completed her studies, she along with her husband started a school for girls in Pune in 1848. Along with her husband, with the guidance of her husband, Savitribai Phule started a school for girls in Pune in 1848. That is why in 1848, a first school opened for women or girls, and Savitribai Phule became the first female teacher for that school. So, this is the picture of Jyotiba Phule educating, giving education to his wife Savitribai Phule. Next one, next stanza. When they started a school in 1948, to that school, 9 girls belonging to different castes enrolled themselves as students. At first, 9 girls belonging to different castes, not only male, higher caste and lower caste. They enrolled themselves. Slowly and steadily, she established herself. She means Savitribai Phule established herself. Jyotiba and Savitribai managed to open 5 more schools in the year 1848 itself. They started one school in Pune in 1848. In the same year, they managed to open 5 more schools itself in 1848. In 1852, Jyotiba and Savitribai were ultimately honored by the British for their educational work. They honored by the British government because they started new work, that is educational work, giving education to women or girls and untouchable girls. Next one. You can see the picture. This is the picture of Jyotiba Phule and Savitribai Phule, who are educating women. See next stanza. The next step was equally revolutionary. Their steps were not only about women's education. Their next steps were equally revolutionary. During those days, marriages were arranged between young girls and old men. On those days, marriages were arranged between young girls, means teenage girls, and old men. Men used to die of old age or some sickness, and the girls they had married were left widows. As already I said that, marriage arranged between young girls and old men or aged persons. When the aged persons are dying due to their age or illness, the girls become widow. Thus, widows were not expected to use cosmetics or to look beautiful. When on those days, widows were not expected to use cosmetics or look beautiful. Their heads were shaved and the widows were counseled by society to lead an ascetic life. When the women lost their husbands, then they become a widow. The widow woman, the widow women did not or cannot use cosmetics, and they must look appear as ugly, and the society compelled or forced them to lead an ascetic life or nunnery, like a nun. Next stanza. Savitribai and Jyotiba were moved by the plight of such widows. Jyotiba Phule and Savitribai Phule saw the problems of widow women. That is why they organized a strike against the shaving the heads of widows. They raised the voice against shaving heads of the widow men. They decided to stop shaving heads of the widow women. This was the first strike of its kind. They also fought against all forms of social prejudice. They means Savitribai and Jyotiba Phule also fought against all forms of social prejudice. They were moved to see the untouchables who were refused drinking water meant for the upper caste. The untouchables cannot go and fetching the water from the water source of the upper caste. That's why they were moved to see the untouchables. Next on the. Both Jyotiba and Savitribai opened up their reservoir of water to the untouchables in the precincts of their house. Jyotiba Phule and Savitribai opened up their reservoir of water, place of water, to the untouchables, to precincts of their houses. This is a picture Savitribai Phule and Jyotiba Phule giving water to untouchables from their well. Next. Savitribai was not only involved in educational activities, but also in every social struggle that Jyotiba Rao launched. Once Jyotiba stopped a pregnant lady from committing suicide, promising her to give her child his name after it was born. One day, a pregnant woman going to commit suicide. On that time, Jyotiba Phule stopped her committing suicide and promising her to give her child its name after it was born. Then, Savitribai readily accepted the lady in her house and willing to assume to help her deliver the child. They both agreed and they helped that woman to delivering baby. Savitribai and Jyotiba later on adopted this child, who then grew up to become a doctor, and after Jyotiba's death, lit his fire and completed his duties as a rightful son. After that woman gave birth to the child, Jyotiba Phule and Savitribai Phule adopted that child. After that child grown up, he became a doctor, and when Jyotiba's death, he came and he lit a fire and he completed his duties as a rightful son. This incident opened new horizons for the couple. Next, they thought of the plight of widows in Hindu society. Many women were driven to commit suicide by men who had exploited them. The widow women, the male dominated society, they used and harassed sexually, and the men used that widow women like exploited. Then, therefore, Savitribai and Jyotiba put boards on streets about the delivery home to help such abandoned for women and to look after the newborn. Next. Then, they faced social isolation and vicious attacks from people whom they questioned. They faced social isolation. Social isolation and vicious attacks from the people whom they questioned. After his demise, Savitribai took over the responsibility of Satyashodhaka Samaja. Jyotiba Phule founded the Satyashodhaka Samaja. Satyashodhaka Samaja means seeking truth. After his demise, Savitribai Phule took the responsibility of Satyashodhaka Samaja. Jyotiba and Savitribai championed the cause of peasants and workers as well. Jyotiba Phule and Savitribai Phule not only helped to the women's education or women's liberation, but also they caused the peasants and workers as well. Championed the cause of peasants and workers. They also helped peasants and workers. This is the picture of after demise of Jyotiba Phule, or this is the picture of Satyashodhaka Samaja. Savitribai Phule's teachings to people. Next stanza. In 1868, she welcomed untouchables to take water from her well. In 1868, she welcomed untouchables to take water from her well. She worked relentlessly for the victims of plague. She worked relentlessly for the victims of plague. Plague means kind of a epidemic disease. Where she organized camps for poor children. In the moment of plague, she organized camps for poor children. It is said that she used to feed 2,000 children every day during the epidemic. She herself was struck by the disease while nursing a sick child and died on 10th March 1897. Savitribai Phule died herself while nursing a sick child and died on 10th March 1897. Next. So, one of the greatest personality, a renowned Marathi playwright, said about Savitribai Phule, that is, every Indian woman who is educated today owes Savitribai a debt of gratitude. It means, whoever get educated nowadays, all educated women must always be grateful to Savitribai Phule, because she opened schools for women in 1848. As a result, today all the women getting education. That's why who are got education, all the women must always grateful to Savitribai Phule, says Sushma Deshpande, a renowned Marathi playwright. Okay, dear children, I hope you enjoyed the lesson and you have understood the lesson very well. That's why now I am going to check your understanding. I mean, I am going to ask you few questions. Shall I ask you few questions? Yes, first question. Who opened the first women's school in India? Try to answer yourself. Who opened the First women's school in India? Yes. Savitribai Phule and Jyotiba Phule opened first women's schools in India. Question number 2. When and where was the first school for girls started? When and where was the first school for girls started? Yes, as I said, the first school for girls started in Pune in 1848. Once again, the first school for girls started in Pune in 1848. Question number 3. What does Sushma Deshpande say about Savitribai Phule? Sushma Deshpande said something about Savitribai Phule. What is that? Yes, that is, every Indian woman who is educated today owes Savitribai a debt of gratitude, says Sushma Deshpande. Dear children, let's move on to the next step, that is comprehension or homework. I always telling that homework is intended for your reinforcement of learning. Okay, write down some questions for your homework. Question number 1. What were the major problems she tried hard to tackle? Question number 2. How was Savitribai treated by orthodox men? Question number 3. Why were Jyotiba and Savitribai Phule honored? Once again, please. Why were Jyotiba and Savitribai Phule honored? Question number 4. What was the condition of widows during their time? What was the condition of widows during Savitribai and Jyotiba Phule's time? Next question. How did the couple help untouchables to get drinking water? How did the couple help untouchables to get drinking water? Okay, dear children, these are the questions for your homework. I hope you enjoyed my session and understood my session or teaching. Have a great day, children. This is Parashuram K. Bavi from GHPS Alebandi Arlapur, Taluk and District Koppal. See you. Thank you.
Anudina, anukshana, maniyellu kaliyona, kalikeya hosahadiyali, jotegudi hecheya hakona, santasadi kaliyona.
Yes, sir.
Yes, teacher.
The same, ma'am.